Thank you. Bells on a string, like slow spinning redemption, winding in and winding out. The shine of it has caught my eye and roped me in, so mesmerizing, so hypnotizing. I am captivated, I am vindicated. The diamond in your ring, cut to mirror your intention, oversized and overwhelmed, the shine of which has caught my eye and rendered me so isolated, so motivated. I am certain now that I am vindicated. I am selfish, I am wrong.
In the tailback spot, he might do it, and he does! Russell down the sideline, trying to outrun the Michigan defenders, all the way down to the 15-yard line!
Unbelievable!
On 3rd and 10, Gary Russell almost took it to the barn.
The Michigan defense didn't see Maroney in the backfield and forgot about Russell.
And he has just stunned the Michigan crowd. 61-yard run by Gary Russell. Here it comes.
Watch the offensive line. They all stay on their blocks.
Ellerson gets a good one.
Just stay with your man. Everybody just stayed with their men. Nobody pulling. Huge play.
Gary Russell took the wind out of everybody here, as Gary Russell just took it 61 yards down to the 14-yard line on a 3rd and 10. And with just a little over a minute left in the ball game, Jason Giannini warming up his right leg on the sideline for a possible game-winning kick.
People at home are probably asking, is he any good? Giannini?
He's not bad. Glenn Mason has never beaten Michigan. Michigan has beaten Minnesota 16 straight times. They started playing for the Little Brown Jug back in 1903, and the last time Minnesota beat Michigan was 86. That's one of only two times since 1968. Did I give you enough streaks there? You get the message, I think.
Yes.
And I think the sideline of Minnesota has that same message in mind. It's going to be Jason Giannini, and he'll trot out to try to win the football game for the Gophers, who've come close the last 2 years but have come away with losses. Remember, Rivas on the other side for Michigan had a couple of field goals that might have been the difference. Now it's up to the Minnesota kicker. And Cupido has come out to hold. Giannini for the win. The kick on the way, and it's good. And Minnesota at Michigan, 23-20. We're not quite sure if the game's over, but if it's not, there's only a second or two remaining. And it looks like for the first time since 86, that will be going to Minneapolis. Well, way back in 1903, Fielding Yost of Michigan sent student manager Tommy Roberts out, said, buy that jug. We got to get some decent water. I don't trust them up in Minnesota. Down there on the sideline, and it looks like it's finally going back to Minnesota.
Now what will happen is the captains of Minnesota will come across the field to get it.
Here's the kick, fielded by one of the up men. They're going to try a little razzle-dazzle here. The ball is loose. Preston might get a shot at it. He picks it up and he fumbles it. Still going, and now it's all over. Minnesota has won the jug, and they are coming to the Michigan sideline. What a scene. And what a run by Gary Russell on third and 10. And Minnesota goes 75 yards in 2 minutes and 48 seconds. They kick a field goal to win. And boy, I don't know if there's anything in there right now, but it'd taste pretty sweet to Glenn Mason if he took a swig. First win ever for Glenn Mason, and he's with Lynn Swann.
Well, Coach, first win against Michigan. You just deserve the honor and privilege of saying how that feels at this moment.
You know, Lynn, I think I can't describe it. We talked before the game. I don't want to look backwards, but I was upset the way we played last week. Not taking anything away from Joe Paterno and Penn State. And, we've had some tough battles against Michigan, and I preach all the time, you just hang in there, something good will happen. You know what? I'm going to finally get to see what that damn jug looks like.
Well, you told me you call plays to win. I want you to take a look at this run by Gary Russell. Tell me what was going through your mind as you ran this ball down the sideline.
Well, it's beautiful, I can tell you that. But, you know, I was on the sideline, and I said, you know, we haven't broken one all day. That's unusual for us. And, you know, I just had a feeling. I said, Phil, we're going to win this thing. We're not even going to overtime. And he broke it, and I was surprised he got caught from behind. And the freshman kicker, you know, he's been under some pressure. He's missed some kicks. But he's, like I always said, he doesn't hide behind the water cooler. He's a tough kid, and I love tough kids.
Well, Coach, the Lou Brown Jug is the oldest trophy in college football. You're taking it back to Minnesota. You got an opportunity to put that in your trophy case for the next year. Go enjoy it.
It means a tremendous amount to us, I'll tell you that.
Congratulations,
Thank
Coach.
Thank you very much.